This video explains inner and outer scale, principle of the slide rule, and overview of CRP5, computer face, and we are starting right now. Hello and welcome to Answering ATPL. The focus of this channel is to provide solutions for EASA ATPL questions and other aviation related stuff. Let me know in the comments section below if you are currently taking ATPL theoretical examination. If this is your first time here, consider subscribing to my channel and click on the bell icon to get notified when I publish a new video. The flight computer is used to solve navigational and flight planning problems quickly and easily. In this video series, we will focus on CRP5 flight computer produced by Pooley's flight equipment. The first face is the computer face, and on it back is the second face known as the wind face. In this video series, I will only concentrate on the computer side of the flight computer. The computer side has outer scale and inner scale. The outer scale is fixed. However, the inner scale is free to rotate. There are two index marks on the inner scale. The first one, the blue number 10, is known as the 10 index. It is used for basic numerical calculations. The second one is the black triangle with the number 60, and it is known as the 60 index. It is used for calculations involving time, distance and speeds. First, we will investigate the theory behind the principle of the slide rule. Imagine that you had to add two numbers but had never learned how to do arithmetic. One way of doing this would be to use two rulers. Suppose you had to add 3 and 2. Align 0 on the top ruler, with 3 on the bottom ruler. Now look down from 2 on the top ruler and read of the answer, which is 5. By just this one alignment of the rulers, you can also read off the answer to the sum of 3 plus any other number. You can also subtract by using a similar system. Suppose you want to subtract 1 from 4. Align 4 on the top ruler with 1 on the bottom ruler, and by referring to 0 on the bottom ruler, you can read off the answer, 3, on the top ruler. You just solve the problem, 4 to 1 equals 3. With same relative position of the two scales you have also solved. 5 minus 2, equal to 3. 6 minus 3, equal to 3. 7 minus 4, equal to 3. 8 minus 5, equal to 3. And 9 minus 6, equal to 3. For multiplication, we use a logarithmic scale instead of a linear one. We can see that the numbers along the rulers are not spaced equally. Instead, it is spaced logarithmically. These rulers can be used to multiply and divide, which is more useful. To multiply by 2, align the 1 on the top ruler with the 2 on the bottom ruler. Simply by selecting any number on the top ruler, we can find the answer to that number multiplied by 2 on the bottom ruler. This works with any number. Suppose we want to multiply by 3. Align the 3 on the bottom ruler to the 1 on the top ruler. The rulers are now set to a ratio of 3 to 1. Note that this also works with the position of the 2 reversed. We can have our two rulers like this. Or like this. We can also use this method for dividing. We can divide 6 by 2 and read off the answer 3 on the top ruler against 1 on the bottom ruler. Navigation computer turns our straight line slide rule into a circular one. Before using it, we need to look in detail at the scale. Notice that there is no number smaller than 10, or larger than 99. Therefore, we need to mentally insert the decimal point. For instance, the number 12 is also used to represent 0.12, 1.2, 120, etc. We put the decimal point in after we carry out the navigation computer operation. This means we need to carry out the rough calculation to find out the magnitude of the solution would be. An example will make this concept clearer. Multiply 115 by 2.54. This is approximately 115 rounded down, times approximately 2.5, 2.54 rounded down. Therefore, the answer will be approximately 250. It will not be 2.5, 25, or 2500. To solve the problem, against 11.5 on the outer scale, representing 115, line up the 10 on the inner scale representing 1. Next, find 2.54 on the inner scale, and align cursor over it. Read off the answer. 29.2 on the outer scale. Does this the right answer in order of magnitude? Is the answer 2.92, or 29.2, or 292? We know that the rounded down answer was approximately 250. Therefore, the correct answer is 292. The computer side also has four windows, and they are: altitude window. This window is used to solve true altitude problems. Airspeed window. This window is used to solve true airspeed and Mach number problems. Density altitude window. This window is used in conjunction with airspeed window to find density altitude. Compressibility correction window. This window is used to apply compressibility correction for the true airspeed that is more than 300 knots. Other than the inner and outer scale, the computer face of CRP-5 has several different scales incorporated. Temperature conversion scale. This scale is used to convert between degrees Celsius and degree Fahrenheit. Temperature rise scale. This scale is used to find out temperature RAM rise versus true air speed. Minutes to hours and minutes scale. This circular yellow scale labeled hours in red, that lies within the inner circular slide rule scale. It gives straight conversion between minutes on the inner slide rule scale and hours and minutes on the hours scale. CRP-5 also have a cursor to help us read between two scales easier and much more accurate. Other than that, on the face of CRP-5, there are markers used for conversion within and between SI and imperial units. Now that you know the basic principle and features of CRP-5, use the following videos to find out how to use the many functions of the CRP-5. In the next video, we'll explain ratios, division, and multiplication using CRP-5. If you want to learn more about ATPL or aviation, start now by hitting the round subscribe icons. Also, if you have any questions or comments about ATPL or aviation related problems, you can leave them in the comments section. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.